Sharon was born on Valentine's Day. So he lived up to his birthday. He was a lovable, sweet baby.
Well, he was energetic, funny, maybe even to the point of goofy, very fun-loving and adventuresome, but he had a very serious side.
I think my fondest memory of him as a child was when I saw that he was crying as I was reading the story about the little kitten who lost the mittens.
Well, it was a bit of a surprise when my son decided to join up. He signed up for the Army ROTC program while he was at the University of Montana. So he chose to enlist, and he was actually in Ranger school when 9/11 happened.
It was not totally unexpected, but to hear the date that he was going to deploy was upsetting. I tried not to show the emotion to him on the phone, but I was upset.
Well, that was quite a day, and I come from a military family, so when they said to me, "We regret to inform you," I know what this means. It means he's not hurt, that he was killed in action.
It just happened one particular night. Harvey said, I wish the old Ruth was back. And I realized that that person was no longer in existence. And that made me feel very sad that I wanted her back too. And it was never going to happen.
For about 2 months, every time I heard a helicopter, I just had to rush out and look up. That was kind of a nightmare reaction, I think, looking for somebody in the sky. I mean, how crazy is that?
In our local newspaper, there was an article that said American Gold Star Convention. It was all of these moms who had lost children on active duty in the military. And it hit me. You are a Gold Star mom.
The thing I admire about the organization that has been around for so long, the founder lived here in D.C., and her son was missing in action. So she went down to the Walter Reed Hospital to find him. And she met 25 other moms that were doing the exact same thing. And they realized that all of those wounded were their sons. And that's how we really became a volunteer service organization.
For all of the things that I can't do for Brent, I feel that the next best thing is to serve veterans, to serve military families, to help those that are deployed. If I can make their life a little bit brighter, then it makes me feel better, and I know that my son would be so proud.
I reached out to another mom, and the two of us started our chapter, and it was at that point that I began to see real change. Real change for the better in me.
So I have to say, watching, knowing these women felt like I did, knowing they were where they were, gave me hope.
Well, it helped talk to them because everyone had gone through the same thing I did. It was just something that was just free. And you could just say what you wanted and when you wanted. And if you wanted to cry, they'd hug you.
The Vietnam moms were really very generous in reaching out and sharing their stories. I'm so grateful that they share that whole experience with us, because every time we do the prayer at the Apex, I reach out and I touch the wall, because they're all there together.
Becoming a member of the American Gold Star Mothers allowed me to honor my son.
Thank you.